Hello, sports fans. It's me, Sportsman Z, Bob Zalke. And today, I got a special treat, especially for the White Sox fans out there. Have you ever wondered what it would be like if the all-time White Sox played the all-time Detroit Tigers? Well, you're about to see what would happen, because we have just that type of game coming up for you. Using MLB19 The SHOW, which I think is awesome. And this game, I don't have MLB19 The SHOW myself. This is from a video that was on the Joel Gunn channel. And if you're interested, because he does a whole bunch of games, he does the modern day teams in MLB 19 The SHOW, but with like Hall of Famers are on all the teams, and they're all mixed up randomly. It's not like in some of the games he does, Pete Rose is on the Padres, and Pete Rose was never on the Padres. So it's pretty cool. So again, the channel is Joel Gunn, and I will leave. Actually, I also have a link to his channel on my featured channels on my Face page. But I will leave a link in the description. But I'm pretty excited about this because this is awesome. And I will every now and then I'll be putting up one of the games that he does. Like I'll be doing commentary on it as they go, and and pulling excerpts from the game. I'm not going to do the entire game, but of course any of these games that I show, if you want to see them, just go to his channel because he's got the entire game. But it's like an hour and 47 minutes or something, or, you know, hour and a half or hour and 50 minutes. So I'm not going to show the whole game. I'll show like the highlight portions of the game, and I'll show certain other, you know, times in the game. But generally, I'm not going to show the entire game. But I think it's pretty cool. I love it. And I highly recommend his channel because this is great. This is great stuff. So anyway, let's get on with the game. And so let me see here. Okay, so. Yeah, so here you go. You got Wilbur Wood on the mound for the White Sox facing Ty Cobb. That would be one hell of a matchup. I'd love to see it myself. I don't know if Wilbur Wood really looked like that, but this is cool. I mean, I've actually sat through this game and was like, you know, rooting for the White, just like if I was watching the regular White Sox. It's pretty awesome. I think it's pretty awesome. Of course, Wilbur Wood was famous for throwing knuckleballs. Got Cobb. Yeah, it's Charlie Gehringer, and he can't, I mean, the announcer mispronounces his name every time. It's funny. I mean, I think it's Gehringer. But it sounds like he's saying Charlie Geiger. Ball one. And the catcher, I mean, and I don't necessarily agree with some of the players on these teams, but certainly not on, there's a couple of guys on the White Sox, and I'm like, I don't know. Like, the catcher for us is Sherm Lauer. I'm not so sure I would go with Sherm Lauer. I mean, maybe Przinski, maybe Carlton Fisk, but not Sherm Lauer. That's out. I don't think umpires say that kind of stuff either. Yeah, this looks like a cool game, but I don't have the game system to play it, or I would get it. Looks like a nice sunny day in Chicago, like a real life nice sunny day in Chicago. And some of the looks, it's great too. Sometimes some of the looks on some of these guys' face, it's priceless. Come a long way since like Atari baseball and stuff like that. And even Tony La Russa baseball. I mean, I love Tony La Russa baseball. This is awesome. Norm Cash. Norm Cash doubling off the wall. Miguel Cabrera, who is presently on the Tigers, made the all-time Tigers team. I mean, that's good stuff. Of course, I think this was probably the good version of Miguel Cabrera. He's slipping late. And that's gonna, does that drive in a run? Yep. So Cabrera drove in a run with a single. All right, so now we're going to the bottom of the first. The White Sox coming up, down 1-0. And there's Hal Newhouser on the mound for the Tigers. Hal Newhouser, who apparently had a lot of hair. He's going to face Eddie Collins. I thought that was a good choice for the White Sox at second base. Pretty happy Eddie Collins. And now Luke Appley, another good choice for third base. Appling apparently trying to work a walk here. Newhouser with the pickoff throw. Oh, he's safe. Broken bat. A little base knock. Here we go. Here we go now. Big Frank. Hall of Famer Frank Thomas stepping up. Two runners on, no outs. Not a situation Newhouser would like in real life. It looks like Frank Thomas too. I mean, it really, the batting stance, the look, everything. It's amazing. I mean, I don't know if that looks like Hal Neuheiser or not, but maybe if there's any Detroit fans watching, they can tell me. Come on, Frank, come on. So Frank flies out. There he is, Pauly. Pauly, who may not be getting into the Hall of Fame, but he was a great White Sox player. You see that lineup? That was a nice lineup. I don't know about Maglio or Ordonez in right field, though. I think we could come up with a better choice for right field. I mean, he was good. Don't get me wrong. I love Mags. But I don't know. All-time White Sox? I don't know. And another thing you'll notice is that they have Harold Baines in center. Center field. Harold Baines. So I don't know about that one either. And Pauly strikes out. And there he is, hitting himself in the helmet. Neuhaus is like, what have I got to do? Well, that's it. That's it in the first, 1-0. So we're back at the top of the order again with Luis Aparicio. Shortstop. Oh, wait, no, he wasn't top of the order. No, that was Colin. So this is Luis Aparicio, the shortstop. And, I mean, I would go with him. I think he's a good choice. Obviously, Detroit didn't score in the second. Now we're going to the top of the fourth. Tigers coming up. It's 1-1 because Aparicio hit into a double play at the at-bat that I just showed, but he but those were the first two outs, and there were runners at second and third. So that's how the White Sox tied it. And now Norm Cash is back at the plate. Norm Cash is making woodwork out there. Here's Cabrera again. They got the shift down, the right-handed shift, which you don't see very often. You don't see it as nearly as often as the left-handed shift. Yeah, Miguel Cabrera is making him work too. Oh man, there he goes. Miguel Cabrera goes yard off Wilbur Wood. Man. So the situation now is we're down 3-1 still, and Sherm Lawler just walked, and now Eddie Collins is up. All right, the southpaw. So Eddie Collins up one out, and Sherm Lawler at first. Newhouse is still on the mound. That's going to be a base hit. Yeah, that's a double. Now Appling is up as runners at second and third and one out. I like how they don't say Appling's name. They never say his name. They just say number four. I guess they don't have some names in their database. I don't know. But you would think any player that was in the database that they would have his name, like the announcer would be able to say his name. That's going to get a run in. Now it's 3-2. Big Frank up again. And that's gone. Frank going yard. Now it's 4-3. The White Sox in the lead, loving it. I love the fans in the stands too. They're awesome. And Pauly coming up. That looks like Pauly. That's not a bad representation of him. Come on, Pauly. And that's another one. Another dinger. Paul Konerko going deep. So now we're ahead 5-3. Mags up again. They got Aurelio Lopez warming up in the bullpen. Senior Smoke. Yeah, I mean, our catcher, the catcher they gave us was Sherm Lawler, but Detroit's catcher is Lance Parrish. That seems fair. A little high. And Joe Jackson's on deck. Gotta love that. Eddie Collins, Joe Jackson, reunited. And then they walk Mags, and so here comes Joe. So I think that was a repeat of the I just re-showed that, I suppose. Charlie Geiger, not Gehringer. They brought Eddie Fisher into pitch now. And the score is 5-4 now, so Detroit's closing the gap a little bit. We got Terry Forster up now. Remember him more in the Dodgers, more so than the White Sox. I know he was on the White Sox. Pauly catches it. So Joe Jackson's leading off. They're still only up 5-4, and Detroit brought Hank Aguirre in to pitch to Jackson. Here comes Harold Baines, our center fielder. He flies out. Aparicio, two outs in the bottom of the sixth. Now Lopez and Henneman are up in the bullpen for the play. And it's going to be a fly. Now we're going to the bottom of the eighth. Still up 5-4. Julio Lopez out there. We're still up 5-4 here. Bottom of the eighth. Got two outs now, though. Mags up. Joe Jackson on.